You've been very a strong advocate in involving government and its support from very early on. But on the other hand, some of the scientists and engineers see the involvement of the government as a hindrance, as it sometimes can be against the innovation. Why do you think it's critical to have involvement and support from the government? Really impressed by your leadership and your working with the U.S. government last year to come up with to establish an executive order and bill for AI R&D investment, R&D strategy. Why do you think it's critical to have involvement and support from the government?
Yeah, good question, Songyi. So several questions to unpack here. One is, what did we do, HAI, to involve the government? The second is the bigger question of innovation versus regulation and all that. Last year is that we successfully helped to legislate a bill that agreed to establish a National Research Cloud Task Force to put together a future agenda on how we can increase the investment of academic and public sector AI research by creating a national research cloud to provide the very critically needed compute and data resource to researchers in public sector and academia. And this is a recognition that AI technology is advancing rapidly, and part of the advancement comes from the adequate amount of compute and data. And that's it's a real true technological breakthrough enabled not only by smart algorithms, but also by compute and data. And America had always thrived on this healthy ecosystem of basic science innovation in public sector, entrepreneurship, and a highly efficient industry, you know, technology industry, as well as government's right level of incentive and support. And in the age of AI, because how quickly this technology changed and how quickly private sector became the leaders of this technology with the proprietary compute and data resource, we recognize it's a critical moment for the government to incentivize and to support public sector basic science research. It's not only just for technology innovation, even more importantly, it's for talent education. Because in America, you know, the continued generations of success will come from the people we train. And they come from the universities and colleges. And we need to keep the healthy ecosystem going. So this brings us to the second question is, what's government's role? Should government stay out of this whole thing so that innovation can continue? I do agree that America has a very healthy innovation ecosystem because of its free market and this entrenched entrepreneurial DNA. But I think government has an important role to play. And I don't think it's that different. Even if you look at the beginning of the internet, federal funding played a huge role in establishing the first internet. So the incentives and the federal funds of America has in the past, at least more than a half century since World War II, has been a huge catalyst for America's innovation. So I think that's always a very, very positive role that government has played.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's really important that we compare today's where AI is to where the internet was maybe 30 years ago, when there is a massive rollout and government investment that enabled innovation.
But there is also another side of the government role that's important is regulatory roles. You know, this technology has come of age, has become very powerful. We talked about the biases in the algorithms. the potential harms to people, the privacy concerns, and all the way to, you know, even international orders, government does have a role to put guardrails around technologies that can help, can harm people, and to try to level the playground, you know, measures into the deployment of this technology. And also, a government like US has a role to collaborate with allies and partners to establish a benevolent usage of this extremely horizontal, powerful technology, respecting the kind of human rights, universal human rights that we believe in. So these are all roles government can play without stagnating innovation. The badness is not within the technology. The badness is within people. There's no independent machine values. Machine values are human values. They reflect our human values.